Artificial intelligence, or AI, is increasingly shaping the world in which we live. However, it's only as good as the data you put in, and bad data, tainted by implicit racial, gender, and ideological biases, is common. Unfortunately, many AI systems will continue to be trained using bad data, making this an ongoing issue. A crucial principle for both humans and machines when developing systems is to avoid bias and therefore prevent discrimination. Bad data is not the only issue here. The algorithmic model used is another source of AI bias. In this case, an algorithm is a set of instructions that tell your computer to take a set of inputs and manipulate them to produce an output. As we work to develop AI systems we can trust, it's critical to train these systems using well-balanced data and to develop algorithms that can be easily understood and explained. Over the last few years, Amazon has aggressively marketed its facial recognition technology to local, state, and federal agencies as a tool to help with the identification of suspects. This aggressive push has landed the corporation at the center of an increasingly heated debate regarding the role of facial recognition in law enforcement. In the case of Clearview AI, where the company can not only see who's being researched and who's doing the research, but can also manipulate the results, this raises questions like, should law enforcement's use of facial recognition be subject to human oversight and controls? Just ask Niger Parks, who police identified using facial recognition software and accused of shoplifting and trying to hit an officer with a car, despite him being 30 miles away at the time of the incident. He is the third person known to be falsely arrested based on a bad facial recognition match. In all three cases, the people mistakenly identified have been Black men. This further demonstrates the deployment of this advanced and largely unregulated technology despite its demonstrable bias towards marginalized groups. In the US, there is no single comprehensive federal law regulating the use and collection of biometric data. As of January 2020, California became the fourth state, following Illinois, Texas, and Washington, to pass a biometric data privacy law. As the fifth largest economy in the world and home to big tech, the California Consumer Protection Act has been presented as a potential model for a US data privacy law. This follows a study by MIT Media Lab, which found that Amazon's system, Recognition, experienced increased difficulties in distinguishing the gender of female faces. The research found that 19% of the time, Recognition misclassified women as men and mistook darker-skinned women for men 31% of the time. A broad federal study by the National Institute of Standards and Technology found that facial recognition software is worse at identifying women and people of color than men and white people. Research found these systems had higher rates of false positives for marginalized groups by a factor of 10 to 100 times, with Native Americans as the highest. Another tech giant, Microsoft, led the charge to call on Congress to regulate the technology, arguing that it's too risky for companies to oversee on their own. While advocates see a powerful tool for catching criminals and maintaining law and order, civil liberties experts see an instrument of mass surveillance hindering one's ability to go about their lives in anonymity. There are several concerns regarding bias as organizations now look to AI for help with hiring and promotion decisions. However, contract negotiations between employers and the vendors that sell these algorithms are dominated by an untested legal question. Who is liable when a robot discriminates? The predictive strength of any algorithm is based on, among other things, the information it's fed. This raises concerns that the technology will perpetuate the existing biases against people applying for jobs and unemployment insurance. The use of algorithms in streamlining recruitment is uncharted legal territory created by the adoption of AI to perform business functions normally performed by humans. The AI bias we see today is not a coincidence. As more people question how this seemingly neutral technology has gone astray, it's become increasingly apparent just how important it is to have broader representation in the design, development, deployment, and governance of AI. The underrepresentation of both women and people of color in the tech industry, and the undersampling of these groups in the data sets used to shape AI, have led to a technology that is optimized for only a small slice of the world. Another example of AI bias is an algorithm widely used in US hospitals to allocate healthcare treatments to patients. A 2019 study published in Science found that this potentially life-saving algorithm demonstrated a reluctance to refer Black people over white people who were equally sick to programs that provided care for patients with complex medical needs. A closer look at the data revealed that the cost of care provided to a white person with similar chronic illness was on average $1,800 more per year than that of a Black person. The algorithm assigned risk scores, and with that, high-risk categories based on annual healthcare costs. Thereby, the systemic discrimination of denying healthcare to minorities was passed on in its results. And Black people had to be significantly sicker than white people to be referred for additional care. Of the patients the algorithm referred for additional help, less than 18% were Black. Researchers claim, had the algorithm been unbiased, that number would have been closer to 47%. In addition to concerns about safety, traffic, and moral trade-offs, we also need to worry about the negative impacts of AI bias on people of color. A 2019 study by the Georgia Institute of Technology found that self-driving cars are more likely to hit darker-skinned people because automated vehicles are better at detecting fairer skin tones. Say it louder for the people in the black. As AI takes on a larger role in society, it's critical to have inclusive design, which learns from people with a wide range of abilities and perspectives. It is with this active and intentional engagement that an understanding of how best to design products that better satisfy human diverse needs is reached. In a world of close to 8 billion people, our ambition should be to create products that are appropriate for each one. To achieve this, we must begin by looking at human diversity as the inputs for better design. This not only provides access to products and service experiences for people with a wide range of abilities, it reflects a richer portrait of humanity, showcasing the real and evolving differences among them. Whatever your industry, understand that every design decision you make either raises or lowers the barriers to people using your creation. Thank you.